queens, angels, and goddesses. Welcome back to my channel. Warning, this contains boy love and this is 18 plus. And if you don't like it, then please get off my channel. Water pistol. The 2021 Olympic Games were finished. A winner had been declared. Medals had been awarded. They sat shoulder to shoulder in the second row of the arena, basking in the emptiness of a venue that had been filled just a few hours ago. The silence echoed with the cheers for Japan and Argentina that had bounced all around the room. Their respective teams were long gone, left to celebrate their gold and silver medals with promises of retribution and revenge. No words passed between them, they weren't needed. They both had reached the highest pinnacle of their careers, there were no more goals, no more mountains to climb, no more people to prove wrong. So where did they go from here? Iwazumi had made up his mind the day Oikawa was announced as the starting setter for the Argentina national team. He was finally going to make his move after the Olympics. The only thing left that he wanted was Oikawa, and he was not going to wait another year, or another month, or even another minute for his best friend to get a clue. Oikawa was holding his gold medal in his hands, stroking it gently and staring reverently at the culmination of his dreams. While it would have been preferable to win it while playing for Team Japan, it had felt damn good to destroy the country that had never found him good enough. Iwazumi nudged Oikawa's shoulder with his own, breaking the silence with the question, "What comes next?" Oikawa shrugged, eyes still trained on the medal in his hands, "Honestly, I haven't thought beyond the Olympics." This, he gestured to the arena, clutching the gold to his chest, was the dream. "I don't quite know what to do now that I've finally won." Iwazumi glanced at Oikawa softly, love and admiration filling his eyes. "You and I both know you are going to go back to training to beat Japan again at the Paris Olympics. You don't want to stop until you have achieved world domination, twice." "That thought has crossed my mind," Oikawa smirked, chuckling lightly, "but I'm 27. I think it's time to start thinking beyond volleyball." Iwazumi's heart started to speed up. Was this the moment? Oikawa looked at Iwazumi, who quickly looked away. He was never good at hiding what he was feeling from Oikawa, they had just known each other far too long for that. He could feel Oikawa staring at the side of his face, undoubtedly wondering what had him looking panicked. "Iwa-chan, you look constipated when you think too hard," he said with a poke to Iwazumi's cheek. "What the hell, Shitakura? I do not look constipated." Iwazumi swatted at his hand, feeling a blush threatening to color his face. Oikawa brushed him off, shrugging, "Whatever you say, Iwa-chan. So then what are your plans now that your superstar team lost the Olympics?" Clicking his teeth, Iwazumi took a calming breath, not letting Oikawa push his buttons. He set his shoulders, steeling himself to tell Oikawa what he had been hiding. "Actually, I've decided to switch teams. I've already been offered a position and I move in 2 weeks, after I go spend some time with my mom." Oikawa's mouth dropped open, putting his medal down for the first time since it was placed around his neck. "Another team? Moving? Why didn't you tell me?" Iwazumi shrugged, fighting to keep the smile off his face. "It happened right before the games, so I knew you would be busy. I didn't want to interrupt your practice." Scoffing, Oikawa shifted so he wasn't fully pressed into Iwazumi's side anymore. He turned fully in his seat to look at Iwazumi. He said, "Thank you, Iwa-chan, for not explaining anything to your best friend. Where are you even moving to?" His voice dripped with thinly veiled venom. Iwazumi pulled out his phone to pull up a picture of the city he was moving to. He turned the phone towards Oikawa, letting his eyes rake over the picture. After a beat he said, "You might have heard of it. It's this little city called San Juan." Oikawa froze. Iwazumi smiled. Iwazumi had his full attention, the gold medal slipping off his lap, clinking into the ground at their feet. Iwazumi bent to pick it up, placing it back around Oikawa's neck. "Not gonna say anything, Shitakura? If you're fucking with me right now, Hajime, I might murder you," Oikawa said slowly and clearly. His eyes were shining, clearly trying to not let himself get too excited. Always one to protect himself. Iwazumi rolled his eyes, letting the sound of Oikawa saying his given name wash over him. He was so dramatic, but that was one of the reasons he loved him so much. Iwazumi reached over to grab Oikawa's hand, cradling it gently between his. "Well, I have this plan, but I'm going to need your help. I've accepted a job in San Juan where I'll still get to be a sports trainer. I'll have to come back to Japan to work with the national team, but 9 months out of the year, I'll live in Argentina. A bright smile was spreading across Oikawa's face. The problem is that I don't want to go to Argentina without a contract. Ayazmi said, watching as Oikawa's smile dimmed slightly, confusion coloring his features. But, the company should be offering you a contract? I'm not talking about a contract for a job, dummy caller. Oikawa pulled his hand out from between Iwazumi's. He looked more confused now, and sentimentally fondling his medal. Iwa-chan, I don't understand what you are saying. Iwazumi took his hand again, moving to flick him in the forehead. Damn, and I would have thought that you would remember what you asked me when we were 9 years old in your backyard. You're the sentimental one between us. Oikawa stared at him blankly for a second before remembering his childhood proposal. His face went pink, eyes glancing around in embarrassment. We were kids, Iwa, that wasn't real. I want it to be real. I want to marry you, Toru. I want us to live in Argentina, together. I don't want to lose you to the other side of the world again. I want to stand by your side as you take on the world. I want what we've been putting off for 12 years now. I want a life with you. Iwa. I have many reasons to want to marry you. Would you like to hear some of them? Iwazumi asked, inwardly grinning at Oikawa's nod. He'd finally found a way to shut up his best friend, and he was going to take full advantage of it. He pulled Oikawa's hands apart and spread out his 10 fingers. Number 1, Iwazumi ran his finger up Oikawa's pinky finger on his right hand. You put 110% into everything you do. It makes you overwork yourself, but when you care about something, you make it your sole purpose. You always give your best, and I want to give you the best of me. He moved to touch Oikawa's ring finger. Number 2, your love of aliens rivals my love of Godzilla, so we can be nerds together. I want you to be the one I watch Godzilla movies with, and I'll even watch your alien movies with you. Oikawa nodded, not taking his eyes away from where their hands were touching. Iwazumi touched the tip of Oikawa's middle finger. Number 3, you never give up. I don't know how you do it, but you always find a way to keep fighting. I want to be there to fight alongside you. Number 4, Iwazumi leaned in to place a small kiss to Oikawa's pointer finger. These hands are the most skilled I have ever seen. You're the best setter, hands down. I don't care what anyone else says, these hands were crafted by the gods, and I want to be there to make sure you don't fuck them up. Oikawa giggled, leaning in closer to Iwazumi. Iwazumi turned Oikawa's hand to run his finger up Oikawa's thumb. Number 5, your attention to detail is insane. With you around, I would never lose my wallet or misplace my keys. Oikawa shoved Iwazumi's shoulder. That one is silly, Iwa-chan. I thought you were being sweet, but you just want me for my skills. What a waste of my beauty. He flipped his hair, still smiling. Iwazumi moved on to Oikawa's left hand, unfazed. While touching his left thumb, Iwazumi said, Number 6, you're beautiful. Gorgeous, even. Although it may get annoying having everybody fawn all over you, I want my husband to be the most handsome man in the world. Oikawa tucked his chin down, feeling a mixture of embarrassment and giddiness at the bluntness of Iwazumi's words. Number 7, Iwazumi touched his other pointer finger. You are serious yet silly, and you never fail to make me laugh. I know with you that when I need to be lifted up, you will be there to make me smile, but when we need to buckle down and do something, you will be fully committed. I want to be fully committed to you. Number 8, you are so ambitious, it's scary. I know things have been hard. I know that there were times you questioned why you worked as hard as you do, but you always find a way to come back to what you're best at. I want to be there to always help you find your way. He said as he stroked Oikawa's middle finger. Iwazumi moved to touch Oikawa's left ring finger, eyes going dreamy for a moment. Oikawa held his breath, knowing that whatever would come next would probably be the most important. He pouted when Iwazumi moved on to his pinky. Number 9, it would be pretty nice to be a trophy husband. You're an Olympic gold medalist, how many other people can say they bagged someone of that caliber? They both laughed. Iwa-chan, I think you missed one. Oikawa said, wiggling his ring finger. Iwazumi got serious again, turning Oikawa's hand to hold it in his and placed a kiss on his ring finger, in the spot where a ring would soon lay. Number 10, I feel like we belong together, we just work better than most. I know everything about you, and you know everything about me. Who cares that we haven't officially called it dating? We have practically been together our whole lives. We are soulmates who met at birth and have grown together for 27 years. I say it's about time to make it official, because Iwazumi paused, looking up from their joined hands to stare into Oikawa's eyes. I love you, Toru. I have loved you my whole life with every fiber of my being, and I can't live without you. Oikawa's eyes were wet with unshed tears, understanding written all over his face. Iwazumi knew he felt the same, and that gave him the strength to say, Oikawa Toru, will you marry me? Suddenly, Iwazumi found himself with a lap full of a gold medalist setter. Oikawa looked down at Iwazumi, a smile on his face while tears spilled down his cheeks. Hajime, I think I'd like to kiss you now, Oikawa whispers, lips a breath away from Iwazumi's. Instead of the nice feeling of warm lips covering his own, Oikawa felt Iwazumi's finger push against his mouth. I asked you a question, Toru, and I need an answer before I kiss you, Iwazumi said, moving his finger away so Oikawa could speak. Oikawa looked at him through hooded eyes. Me and more, life has always been leading us down this path. Of course I'll marry you. Iwazumi's eyes shined. Alright then, he whispered as he let out the breath he didn't know he was holding. They sat there, Iwazumi's hands resting on Oikawa's hips, Oikawa's around Iwazumi's neck. Now that you got your answer, can you kiss me, Iwa-chan? Iwazumi didn't even have to think about it before he was leaning in to kiss Oikawa. The kiss wasn't inherently special or magical. They fumbled for a second trying to line up correctly. Their teeth clinked together. But once they got it, they got it. Iwazumi squeezed Oikawa's hips, letting his fingers trail up his shirt, feeling the heat of his skin. Oikawa groaned in the back of his throat, turning his head to deepen the kiss. Iwazumi opened his mouth, breathing in Oikawa, licking at the seam of his lips, asking for entrance. He let out a small gasp at the feeling, not realizing Iwazumi would be so forward. That moment gave Iwazumi the opening he needed, though, and he molded their mouths together heatedly hotly. He licked into his mouth, tasting his tongue. Oikawa was so wrapped up in the feeling of Iwazumi in his mouth and around his body that he didn't even notice the way his hips started moving on their own, pressing into Iwazumi's lap. He pulled away for air, gasping, Iwa, oh my gods, Iwa. He let his head roll back, Iwazumi kissing the line up his neck to the sensitive spot behind his ear. He was grabbing onto Iwazumi's mane, nails raking up into his hair as his hips continued to grind into the body below him. Iwazumi was nibbling and sucking at his neck, clearly marking his territory when Oikawa noticed that he was hard. His face went bright red and he scrambled to pull away before Iwazumi noticed. He was kissing him like he wanted to devour him whole, but they had only elucidated their relationship minutes before. He shouldn't be this horny. The way his body was reacting, he felt like a teenager. Oikawa was trying to scooch away from Iwazumi's firm grip, unable to retreat that far in the arena seats. He pulled his hands from Iwazumi's hair, pushing against his chest and trying to cover the obvious bulge in his pants with his shirt. Iwazumi growled at the movement, biting down on Oikawa's neck hard. The squeak Oikawa let out was embarrassing, but that wasn't his current concern. He needed to get off of Iwazumi's lap, and hurry to the bathroom to splash some cold water on his face before he made a complete and utter fool of himself. Iwa-chan, wait, Oikawa said, voice husky with arousal. Iwazumi pulled back from Oikawa's neck, looking up at him with dark eyes, lips shiny with spit. Oikawa's mind went blank, seeing the amount of passion in the face of the man who he never dreamed to call his lover. He momentarily forgot why he was trying to get away, when all he wanted was to get closer, and feel Iwazumi all over his body. He dug forward, mouth open, meeting the waiting lips of the man below him. He let his hands wander over the expanse of Iwazumi's back that he could reach, gripping onto his shirt like he would float away without something to hold onto. Iwazumi pulled him tight against his body, pushing their hips together, both men making a noise as their arousals rubbed together. They kissed like there was nothing else in the world, no separate teams, no distance to keep them apart, no janitors coming to kick them out to clean the arena. I have wanted this, Iwazumi said in between kisses, for so long, you have no idea. He was nipping at Oikawa's lips, sucking on his bottom lip, drawing small whimpers from Oikawa. Imozumi leaned back, moving one hand to hold Oikawa's neck and jaw, his large, calloused hands gripping tightly. He trailed his fingers down slowly, causing Oikawa to close his eyes, savoring the feeling. He flinched, feeling Imozumi press onto one of the newly formed bruises coloring his neck. Imozumi leaned close, following his fingers with gentle kisses, whispering mine over each spot. Oikawa had been with other lovers before, he was a 27-year-old, red-blooded male. But he had never gotten so hard, so quickly, from just kissing and gentle touches. He was throbbing in his pants, each gentle press of Iwazumi's fingers and mouth rousing flutters deep in his belly. Oikawa was fully rocking now, clutching onto Iwazumi, chasing more of the addicting feeling against his body. Iwazumi threaded one hand into Oikawa's hair, pulling roughly to bring their faces back together. His other hand still held tightly to his hip, helping to move him in the grind they were creating. Iwazumi thrusted up to meet Oikawa, forcing Oikawa to feel his erection against his own. Toru, I want you. Iwazumi groaned into Oikawa's mouth. You have me, Mia Moore, and now you can't get rid of me. Oikawa said, smiling against Iwazumi's lips, kissing him again. No, idiot. Iwazumi grabbed at Oikawa's ass, moving their hips together harder. I want you. Oikawa whimpered, frantically moving against him. Then take me, he whispered, trying to sound sexy despite his climbing anxiety. This was Aya-chan, his best friend, and now his fiancé. And they were dry humping in the Olympic Stadium. Oikawa would be lying if he claimed to never have dirty fantasies that played out similarly, but never did he dream it could be reality. What if he disappointed him? Who would take top? Oikawa usually took the lead in these situations, but he was like putty in Iwazumi's hands, whimpering and whining, desperate to be surrounded by this man. He had never felt like this before. Not here, dumb Oikawa. I am not fucking you where you just kicked my team's ass. Iwazumi said, still not making any move to stop their desperately moving bodies. Oikawa whined, pressing down harder, letting his hands grope over Iwazumi's abs and chest. We have been waiting for this for years, and you think I can wait until we get back to the hotel? You clearly don't know me very well, Iwa-chan. Iwazumi grabbed at Oikawa's hips, lifting him off his lap and forcing him to stand on his own. He quickly tried to adjust himself in his pants, until Iwazumi stood and he could see just how affected the other man was, as well. He grabbed his hand and started pulling him through the rows of seats and down onto the court. Iwa-chan, where are we going? Iwazumi turned his head, his eyes dark and lips pulling into a dangerous smirk. Thought you couldn't wait. Not backing out on me now, are you? Iwazumi turned back forward, continuing to pull Oikawa, leading him out the doors and down the hallway leading to the locker rooms. They didn't stop until they were in front of a door, still labeled with a large sign reading Team Japan on it. Wait, actually, I don't want to be pressuring you or anything. Iwazumi ran a hand through his hair. We could just go back to the hotel and hang out the rest of the night. I am sure you are tired. Actually, this was kinda dumb and presumptuous of me. I'm sorry. Oikawa cut off Iwazumi's ramble with a kiss, pushing him into the doorframe, using his height as an advantage to try and take control of their kiss. He slid his hands up Iwazumi's shirt, mewling as his fingers ran over the planes of his abs. Oikawa knew that Iwazumi was muscular, he had been since high school, but feeling it was a whole new experience. Iwazumi let Oikawa play, feeling his long fingers drag over his overheated skin and their tongues roll around each other. He gripped the front of Oikawa's shirt, pulling him in closer, grumbling deeply in his chest as Oikawa raked his nails down Iwazumi's chest. He reached around, letting his fingers dip into the waistband of Oikawa's pants with one hand, while the other blindly felt behind himself to find the handle and push open the door, sending both men stumbling back into the darkness. Their lips didn't separate as they stepped backwards, Iwazumi flipping their position, and walking Oikawa backwards until his back hit the wall of lockers. Oikawa's hands were still up Iwazumi's shirt, roaming all over his skin, drinking in his chiseled lines and soft curves like he was memorizing his body. He was lit up, his skin tingling with every pass of Oikawa's bare skin on his own. He pulled back, panting, looking up slightly at the man his body was pressed against. He felt his breath catch at the sight of Oikawa's disheveled state. His usually perfect hair was masked, lips bitten red and swollen, and he could see the bruises starting to bloom on the porcelain skin of his throat. His heart was pounding, wanting to pour his years of yearning into this moment. His desire clouded his vision, body moving without conscious thought, diving back forwards to lap at Oikawa's exposed neck. The need to taste Oikawa so strong, there was nothing in the world that could tear him away. He felt as though his blood was superheated, rushing through his veins so intensely he could barely contain his teeth and tongue. His hands wandered, gripping at Oikawa's skin so tightly he was sure to leave bruises. His desperation to keep this man close to him made him forget his strength as he squeezed and kneaded at Oikawa's body. He was willing to do anything Oikawa asked, anything to keep Oikawa here with him, right now and for the rest of time. He pushed his hips up against him, only the clothing on their bodies separating them. Oikawa, consciously or not, moved his legs apart slightly, making more room for Iwazumi to surge forward, pressing harder against him. Oikawa pulled at the fabric of Iwazumi's shirt, making a needy sound that shot directly to Iwazumi's throbbing core. He didn't want to separate for even a moment, but the thought of feeling Oikawa's bare chest pressed against his allowed Iwazumi to pull back, lifting his arms long enough for Oikawa to rip off his shirt and drop it next to them. The moment his arms were free, he was pulling at Oikawa's shirt, probably stretching it out in his haste to remove it. Seeing the new expanse of smooth skin in front of him drove all thought from Iwazumi's head, including the slight apprehension he had been feeling about fucking Oikawa in a public arena where someone might stumble in on them. He kissed Oikawa's lips, moving lower to kiss over his jaw and back down to the sweet spot on his neck that caused Oikawa to gasp. He continued to kiss over his collarbone and over his chest, letting his teeth drag down, ducking his head to mouth over his nipple. Oikawa pulled in a sharp breath, fingers tightening where they were holding onto Iwazumi's shoulders. He licked over the same spot again, savouring the noises coming from the other man. Oikawa was breathing hard, chest raising concerningly fast, as Iwazumi nibbled and sucked over his exposed skin. Iwa-chan Oikawa moaned, digging his nails into Iwazumi's skin, grinding his hips forward into Iwazumi's thigh. Iwazumi bit down gently once more, before trailing kisses lower, licking at his skin, and leaving soft nibbles down Oikawa's firm abdomen. He slid his hands down Oikawa's sides, as he moved to kneel in front of him. He let his blunt nails leave trails down Oikawa's skin until he was met with the waistband of Oikawa's pants. Iwazumi looked up, eyes unfocused, "Please Toru, can I?" Oikawa could only nod, throwing his head back into the lockers as Iwazumi pulled his pants down to his ankles. Iwazumi took a second to admire, sitting back on his heels as he took in the groggy body that stood before him. Oikawa's hands fluttered for a moment, unsure of where to put them, the desire to cover himself from the scrutiny of Iwazumi's gaze battling the sheer need to thrust into the warmth of his mouth. The weight of Iwazumi's eyes raking up his body was palpable, until their eyes met again. "You're so fucking perfect," was all Iwazumi said before taking him in his mouth. He wasted no time, taking Oikawa all the way to the back of his throat in one go, making Oikawa's knees tremble and his back arch. Iwazumi's mouth was so hot and so wet, if he thought he felt like a teenager before with how quickly he got hard, it was nothing compared to how quickly he thought he might bust. Oikawa fisted one hand in Iwazumi's hair, gripping on for dear life, while the other covered his mouth, trying to muffle the onslaught of noises leaving him. Iwazumi was bobbing his head just right, pulling almost all the way off his cock and then pushing as far forward as he could go, until his nose was nestled in Oikawa's pubic hair. The feeling was like nothing Oikawa could describe. His thoughts were far and few between, slipping like liquid through a sieve, his brain unable to grasp onto any of them. Iwazumi was gripping onto Oikawa's thighs, giving himself leverage as he slid his mouth over him. Tears were pricking in the corners of his eyes, the back of his throat fluttering around the intrusion. Oikawa thrust forward once, causing Iwazumi to gag, pulling off to cough and wipe his mouth. "Shit, Iwa-chan, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to." Iwazumi looked up at him, smiling before dropping his jaw and tightening his neck. Oikawa paused, his brain struggling to catch up to the sight spread out below him, before thrusting forward into Iwazumi's waiting mouth. He threaded both hands into Iwazumi's hair, holding on as he set a gentle pace, trying not to hurt him. Iwazumi opened his eyes, narrowing them, before pushing forward harder, causing Oikawa to slip down his throat again. Oikora let out a low moan, holding himself deep in Iwazumi, savouring the feeling of wet heat around him. Iwazumi's throat was constricting, trying to adjust to the depth. He moaned, the vibrations sending fireworks up Oikora's crotch. He pulled back, only to thrust back in hard, sending Iwazumi sinking back onto his heels again before quickly righting himself. Iwa, it's too good. I'm gonna, fuck. Oikora felt his core tightening and his toes curling. Iwa-chan. Hajime, I'm gonna you have to stop. Oikora tried to pull away, but Iwazumi pulled him back by the legs, bobbing his head harder until he felt Oikora spill onto his tongue, hot and salty. Oikora let out a guttural moan, knees going weak as his legs shook. Iwazumi kept a light pressure on his dick with his mouth, savouring the twitching aftershocks on his tongue. Oikora started to whimper with oversensitivity when Iwazumi finally pulled off, licking his lips and wiping the tears that had leaked from his eyes. Oikora started sliding down the lockers, pins and needles shooting through his legs. He caught himself before he landed with his bare ass on the dirty locker room floor, forcing himself to stand and pull up his pants. Iwazumi was still below him, sitting on his knees, a heavy outline of his still rock-hard dick down his thigh. He stood, eyeing Oikora's still trembling form like a predator stalking his prey. He slid up Oikora's body, taking his face in his hands and kissing him deeply, forcing Oikora to taste himself in Iwazumi's mouth. Iwazumi walked them backwards until his knees met the bench and he sat down, pulling Oikora into his lap. He ran his hands down Oikora's thighs, kneading feeling back into them. You all right there, Toru? Iwazumi smirked, kissing the junction of Oikora's neck. Oikora sighed, relaxing into the comfort of Iwazumi's hold. They sat there for a moment, until Oikora could get his bearings back. Oikora's head was still a little fuzzy, but he was coherent enough to feel the hardness below him and formulate a plan. A, happy, eres enorm, I love feeling you underneath me. Oikora whispered into Iwazumi's ear, the mix of Spanish and Japanese making Iwazumi shudder. Oikora tentatively rolled his hips once, letting out a soft breath against Iwazumi's skin as he felt him twitch in his pants. You like that, happy? You like when I talk to you like this? He rolled his hips again, firmer, circling them as he moved. Iwazumi bit down into Oikora's shoulder again, trying to muffle his sounds. Let me hear you, guapo, you're so sexy moaning for me. Oikora put his hands on Iwazumi's shoulders for leverage, grinding and pushing down into Iwazumi's lap. No pudo espera que ni falls, Iwazumi grunted, hips moving up to meet Oikora's on their own accord. Oikora could feel his thick length against his ass, throwing his head back with a sigh at the thought of it being inside of him. Me lo daris duro? I don't know what the fuck you're saying, but don't stop, please, don't stop, Toru. Iwazumi said through gritted teeth, thrusting up into Oikora's ass. He was going to come just from Oikora whispering sweet nothings that he couldn't understand into his ear and gyrating on his lap. You're so hot, Hajime, Oikora purred, Quiero provocada party de ti. I want to lick down your abs and swallow your cock. I can feel how big it is against me, is it even going to fit inside me? Fuck. Toru, Iwazumi moaned his name, hips stuttering before his whole body tensed. He dropped his head into Oikora's chest, breathing hard. Iwa-chan? Oikora asked quietly, causing Iwazumi to look up at him. Did you just come in your pants? Iwazumi's face went bright red, but he still had a hard look in his eyes. I'm not done with you yet, pretty boy. I am going to destroy you when we get back to the hotel. Oikora sucked in a breath, all smugness gone from his face. Oikora slid off Iwazumi's lap, standing on his still shaky legs. Iwazumi looked down at his lap, wrinkling his nose at the mess in his pants. Gross. He stood and adjusted himself, glancing down to make sure the stain wasn't too noticeable. He grabbed their shirts from the floor, handing Oikora his so they could get dressed. After they were somewhat presentable, Iwazumi grabbed his hands and they walked out together. Dash. Oikora and Iwazumi slipped out the door of the arena, glad to have missed most of the press. Iwazumi had Oikora's team bag slung over his shoulder, using the bag to cover the front of his pants the best he could. Their hands were laced together, the night air cool on their skin. I need another shower, Iwa-chan. I feel all gross. You need another shower? You're not the one with drying cum in their boxers, fucking menace. Aizumi said, walking slightly bow-legged. Aikora giggled at him, bumping their shoulders. Didn't hear you complaining before, Mitesoro. Aizumi scoffed at him, pulling his hand back before Aikora grabbed onto him again. So, Aikora started your own or mine? Aikora cocked his head at Aizumi, flirtatiously. Aizumi's steps stuttered, having easily fallen back into the normality of their relationship, forgetting that there is a new normal, now. Hey, Toru, can I ask you a serious question? Aizumi's voice was quiet and his eyes were firmly faced forward as they walked down the sidewalk. Aikora felt nervousness creep into his bones, unsure of what was coming next. Of course, Aiwa-chan, Aikora said, staring at the side of Aizumi's face, you can ask me anything. When was the last time you slept with someone? Like, I don't care, per se, but I just feel like I should know. I haven't been with anyone in quite a while, to be honest with you. I have known for a long time that no one could replace you in my heart, and even just using someone to get off felt dirty after a while. Pink started to dust Aizumi's cheeks, steeling himself for the Aikora's response. He felt like he couldn't be jealous, but the thought of someone touching Aikora, his fiancée, made his blood boil. Oh Aiwa-chan, Aikora's voice was saccharine, full of love and quiet admiration. I'm not going to lie to you, he could see Aizumi tense, fingers twitching in Aikora's hold. It has been a long time for me, too. He squeezed Aizumi's hand three times, silently saying I love you. Also, I just got tested before the Olympics, and I'm clean, if that's what you were worried about. Aizumi's shoulder sagged, embarrassed at how relieved he felt. Me, too. They walked quietly down the road, exhilaration starting to buzz through both men. They barely made it into Aizumi's hotel room before their mouths were connected again. They stripped their clothes with little finesse, the desire to press their naked bodies together too strong to tease. Aizumi ran his hands up Oikora's sides, pinning his hands above his head to the wall as he sucked on his chest. You taste so fucking good, Oikora. God, I want to taste you every day for the rest of my life. Aikora moaned, a tremble running down his spine at the words and the memory of being seated in Aizumi's mouth. And I am going to. I am going to worship this body until the day I die. Aizumi whispered into Aikora's skin. Aikora was getting so hard so quickly that his head was starting to spin. His hips were canting forward, desperation seeping out of him. His cock was at attention, pressing into Aizumi's abs, his crekin leaping out onto his skin. Aizumi pulled back so quickly, Aikora stumbled forward, feet catching on the carpet. Come with me, Aikora. Aizumi's voice was low and gruff, his arousal back with full force. He took his hand and led him to the bathroom, pushing his hips against the cool counter before turning to turn the shower on. Aikora hopped onto the counter, watched Aizumi's naked body move, his muscles bunching and stretching as he leaned into the shower to turn it on and check the temperature. His eyes trailed down over Aizumi's broad shoulders, down to his lats, which were stretching so deliciously that Oikora's mouth started to water. His eyes kept going lower, over the dimples at the small of his back, and over his firm ass. Aizumi turned as Oikora's eyes made it down to his thick thighs, imagining himself dying between them. Enjoying the view, Pervikora? Aikora snapped back to attention, realizing a moment too late that his head was cocked, unabashedly leering at the man in front of him. Yeah, I am, Aikora said with a sturdy voice, even with a blush creeping down his neck, what are you going to do about it? He let his head drop to the side, hair bouncing with the movement, filling Aizumi with the overwhelming urge to yank on it to bring their bodies back together. Aizumi closed the distance with long steps, threading his hand through Oikora's chestnut hair, gripping on tight to his scalp and pulling their mouths together in a bruising kiss. Aikora whimpered, pushing harder into the kiss. Te necesito, papi, please, Aikora breathed, hands sliding down to grip at Aizumi's leg. He let out a hiss at the contact, thrusting up into Oikora's hand. Get in the shower, Aizumi said, letting Aikora slide down the counter and get into the glass-paned shower. Aikora glanced over his shoulder, stepping in, the steam curling around his lean body. Aizumi blinked, Aikora looked otherworldly as he moved under the streaming water, opening his eyes and beckoning to Aizumi. Get in here with me, Aiwa-chan. Let me feel your body. Aizumi's eyelids dropped, taking a breath as he moved to get in the shower with Aikora. Okura lifted his hands to wet his hair fully, arms flexing with the movement. Ayazumi leaned back against the opposite wall, arms crossed, watching as Okura shampooed his hair. As Okura rinsed his hair, Ayazumi lathered up the washcloth and started to drag it over Okura's body. Okura kept his eyes closed, letting the feeling of Ayazumi's hands and the soft cloth soak into his skin, so he didn't have time to prepare himself when he felt Ayazumi reach around to start groping over his ass. He dragged the washcloth up through his crotch, finger gently teasing over his hole as he passed it. Okura let his heavy breathing be covered by the rushing water. Ayazumi caught the sound though, and repeated the movement, watching as Okura's chest heaved. Iwa-chan, you're at ease. Okura breathed as Ayazumi dragged the washcloth over the rest of his body. Ayazumi chuckled and leaned into the spray to kiss him. Okura met his kiss and pressed forward until they were out from under the water. He blindly reached for the body wash, lathering it in his hands and running them down Ayazumi's body. He slid his arms around Ayazumi's neck, rubbing their soapy chests together. Ayazumi groaned as Okura lightly dragged his nails down his back. He rutted up into Okura's thigh, pushing them back under the water. We're clean. I'm tired of waiting, I need you. Now. Ayazumi's tone was gruff, his desire to be inside Okura so intense he barely recognized his own voice. They stepped out of the shower, toweling off quickly before racing to the bed. Okura laid down, spreading his legs to allow Ayazumi to crawl in between them. He kissed him and it was all tongues and teeth, passion sparking between them like fireworks, electricity tingling across their skin. Ayazumi reached down, taking hold of both of their lengths, stroking lightly. The feel of Okura against him made his dick twitch, heat already stirring in his belly. Ayazumi rolled off of Okura, standing to grab lube from his bag. When he laid back down, he grabbed for Oikora's legs, pulling him on top of his chest. Okura grabbed the headboard of the bed for support, looking down at Ayazumi curiously. Ride my face, Toru, I want to taste you. Okura shivered at his words, Kraken dripping out of his cock as he moved up to hover over Ayazumi's face. He hesitated momentarily, and in that moment, Ayazumi wrapped his arms around his thighs and pulled him down. He wasted no time, lapping and sucking at Oikora's ass, pulling moan after luscious moan from the man above him. Okura wasn't as tight as he expected, his tongue slipping in with little pressure. He pushed his tongue in and out a few times before pulling Okura down harder on his face and slowly dragging him across his mouth. Okura was fully kneeling, hands gripping the headframe so tightly his knuckles were going white. Okura had his eyes screwed up tight, trying not to hyperventilate at the way he was being eaten open. Ayazumi's mouth was so hot and wet, he could feel the saliva leaking out from him as he rocked back and forth. His cock was so hard the tip was going dark and he could feel his pulse in the shaft. He wanted to reach down and grab himself, but he didn't trust himself to stay upright without the help of his hand holds. Ayazumi was moaning under him, nails digging into his flesh. He sounded like he was in heaven, like he didn't want to be anywhere else in the world than where he was. Okura's legs started shaking, his core tightening, when Ayazumi finally pulled away for a breath, tossing Okura over to the side and kneeling on the bed. He wiped his face and lubed up his fingers, grabbing Oikora's leg with his clean hand and dragging him down the bed. Okura was not a small man. He was tall and strong, he had the body of a professional athlete but Ayazumi was moving him around like he was a doll, spreading his legs and positioning him to his heart's desire. He thrust two fingers in quickly a few times before pushing in a third, making Oikora's back arch, a moan getting caught in his throat. He thrashed his head back and forth, whimpers coming from his open mouth, and legs kicking out. Ayazumi scissored his fingers, stretching Okura out so deliciously. Iwa, please, enough. Get inside me, right fucking now. Ayazumi pulled back, wiping his fingers on Okura's leg. He hitched Okura's legs up, bending him in half and lining himself up. He bent down to whisper in Okura's ear while I fuck you, call me Hajime. And with no further comment he thrust in hard, to the hilt. Both men let out long moans, Ayazumi dropping his head, and Okura dragging his nails down Ayazumi's back. Fuck, 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 fuck. Hajime, holy fuck. Okura wailed. Ayazumi bit back sounds of his own, hips twitching in desperation to fuck hard into the tight heat. It was so tight, too tight. Toru, you need to try and relax. His legs were shaking, he was trying to relax his core, but he could feel Iwazumi so deep inside of him, he couldn't help but clench down. Iwazumi pushed himself up gently, running his hands down Oikawa's sides and rubbing circles into his hips. "Shh, it's okay," Iwazumi pulled out a tiny bit and Oikawa squeaked. Iwazumi reached down to stroke Oikawa's cock, while the other hand continued its path down his body. "Baby, you need to relax, I don't want to hurt you." Oikawa clenched his teeth, trying to focus on the feeling of Iwazumi's hands on his body and not on how he was being fucking impaled. He was stretched, he wanted this, so why was his body freezing up? "Talk to me, Hajime, please, keep talking to me. Otoru, you're so good for me, so beautiful, so strong." Oikawa whimpered, forcing the muscles in his legs to go limp around Iwazumi. "I love you so much, this is so overwhelming, yeah. I have wanted to be inside you for so many years, it's embarrassing. You were my first wet dream, did you know that?" Oikawa cracked one eye, smiling slightly up at Iwazumi. "What was the dream, Iwa-chan?" Oikawa said breathlessly. "I barely remember it now, but we were like 13. I dreamt of your body under mine and I woke up to sticky boxes. I couldn't look you in the eyes for like 2 days. Iwazumi had Oikawa's attention on his story, so he moved to pull out a little bit more and gently push back in. Oikawa's eyelashes fluttered but Iwazumi could feel him relaxing. "I thought I was going crazy because I couldn't stop getting hard when I thought about you for a while." Oikawa huffed out a laugh that tilted into a moan on the end as Iwazumi thrust into him again. Iwazumi pulled out and lubed himself up more, and when he slid back into Oikawa, it was like two puzzle pieces fitting together. Oikawa sighed, hips pressing up to meet Iwazumi's. "Are you okay now?" Iwazumi asked, dropping to kiss Oikawa softly. "Yeah, move, please." Iwazumi slid out and pushed back in oh so slowly, dragging a hiss through his teeth at the sensation. He pulled out again and slammed back in, Oikawa scrambling to grab onto his shoulders and back. Iwazumi kept up the pace, unable to hold himself back anymore, his mind going blank and his only goal was to chase the tension coiling around the base of his dick. He fucked into Oikawa over and over, the sound of Oikawa's moans barely covering the sound of their hips slapping together. "So big, mass, 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 please, poor Ali, oh my god." The words were pouring out of Oikawa's mouth with little thought and no meaning. His mind was blank, heat buzzing under his skin, fire lapping at his belly. His nerves were frayed, every thrust of Iwazumi that hit his prostate causing flashes of light behind his eyes. He could feel his muscles tightening, sucking Iwazumi in. He ran his nails down Iwazumi's back hard enough to leave marks, whining so high-pitched his throat hurt. He wrapped his legs around Iwazumi, clinging onto him, "I'm gonna come, Hajime. You're going to make me come." Iwazumi grunted, thrusting harder, hands gripping onto skin. "Please, please, please, please," Oikawa whimpered, breath catching in his chest as his orgasm ripped through his body. It started at his toes, lightning snaking up through his body, and pooling in his pelvis. He gasped out to Hajime as his balls tightened up and he started to come. Iwazumi's quads started to cramp as he tried to maintain his movements all the while his orgasm threatened to spill as Oikawa's ass tightened and pulsed around him. He bit down on Oikawa's neck, breathing hard through his nose as he fucked Oikawa through his climax. Oikawa's body went limp, body twitching with aftershocks. Iwazumi slowed his pace, toes curling. "Toru, you feel so fucking good." His arms were shaking, he was holding on by a thread, wanting to keep himself from coming to prolong the feeling of being buried inside Oikawa a little longer. He could feel Oikawa's hot breath on his neck, his mouth hanging open, panting in his post-orgasm haze. "Hajime, come inside me." That was it, Iwazumi's concentration shattered and his whole body froze as his load exploded deep into Oikawa's ass. Letting out a moan, he came so forcefully that his vision momentarily went dark before slowly coming back into focus. His hips twitched as he collapsed on top of Oikawa. They both panted against each other's skin, air growing humid around them. Iwazumi peeled out gently, rolling to the side and dropping his arm over his eyes. "Holy fucking shit, Oikawa." Oikawa huffed a laugh and rolled towards him, snuggling into his chest. "I am all gross again. I'm going to have to shower, again." Iwazumi laughed, "Well, when I can feel my legs again, I will help clean you up." They laid together, letting their hearts and breathing settle. Ayazumi played with Oikawa's fingers, bringing his hand to his face and dropping soft kisses on his fingers and wrist. His other hand stroked over his skin, as they whispered to each other. "Hey, Aya-chan," Oikawa started, his tone mischievous. "Just because you asked me to marry you and fucked me senseless, doesn't mean you get out of getting me a proper engagement ring." Ayazumi groaned playfully, rolling over to smother Oikawa in kisses and tickling Oikawa's sides until the room was filled with giggles. "Whatever you want, Toru, as long as I get to be with you in the end." Warning: this fanfiction does not belong to me, neither does the fan art. Credits to the original artist and author to the fan art and the fanfiction. Hey Kylie does not belong to me either. Well bye children, smiling face with hearts.